Hello students, today I want to explain about distance and displacement, okay, with general examples. Of course you know what is distance and what is displacement. So let us try to write the definition of it first, later we'll go in detail, okay. Distance, what do you mean by distance? Distance is nothing but path length. While you are traveling, you might have covered one path, no? If you measure the length of the path, the length of the path is nothing but distance. What is displacement? If you consider only starting point and ending point, where you have started, where you have reached, between those two points, let us suppose you have started here at point A and you have gone to another point B. Whatever may be the path, we are not considering the entire path here. We are considering only the starting point and ending points. If you imagine a straight path between these two points, the length of that particular path, the shortest distance between A and B is nothing but displacement. So, displacement is the shortest distance. Usually, both appears to be same, but practically, definitely they are different. Where you come across these in our day-to-day life? Let us try to understand by means of a general example, okay. You want to go to a newly started IKEA showroom from your house in a car, let us suppose. Immediately what you will do, exactly where it is, we don't know. We don't know the location. We want to know that. So immediately what you will go for? We will go for Google Maps. So in the Google Maps, where you are and where you are supposed to reach. If you feed those two, then immediately on the Google Map, you will get a map. And there it displays how much time to reach that particular place, what is the tentative distance from your house to that point. Okay, roughly it shows how much distance that particular IKEA showroom from your house. So that displayed one in the Google Maps will tell us the distance of it. Say for example, it has shown you some 35 kilometers from your house to IKEA showroom. If you want to go to that, simply, blindly, if you travel 35 kilometers in a particular direction, maybe towards left or right or whatever it may be, 35 kilometers simply if you cover, can you able to reach the IKEA showroom? Definitely not. So the distance shown by the Google map will not serve your purpose. Okay. Definitely what you are supposed to do immediately, you need to go for navigation. If you press the button navigate, it shows the picture, that what do you call, the route map for that IKEA showroom. Okay, so there, once you start from your house, it will tell you how much distance you need to cover in a particular direction. Go straight. Let us suppose your house is here, IKEA showroom is somewhere here. You have started your vehicle at this particular point, namely X. IKEA showroom is somewhere at Y. So here you started your Google map. Immediately what it will show? Travel straight. Say 500 meters. Later, it will ask you to take some left or right. So take left and travel a distance of 200 meters. Then it will ask you to travel straight again. Say for example some 1 kilometer. From there, it will ask you to take again right, and it may ask you to take some 10 kilometers. So like that, time to time, it will guide you how much distance you need to travel, in what direction you are supposed to travel. Okay. So finally, let us suppose you have reached IKEA showroom after traveling a distance of 25 kilometers straight. So here from time to time, from point to point, what it is telling us? It is telling us about displacement. How much you need to displace means how many kilometers you need to travel, in what direction you need to travel. So here, is it telling about distance or displacement? It is telling about displacements. How many displacements in what direction you are supposed to make to reach that IKEA showroom? It is telling us. Okay. So like that, the displacement will serve our purpose, but not the distance. If you simply know the distance of that particular destination, it will not serve our purpose. Finally, which is helping us? The displacements which you are supposed to make to reach a particular destination. Okay. So while you are traveling, either on the road or in sea or in air, in flight, simply distance will not serve our purpose. You need to go for displacement. Okay. Let us suppose you are in a ship. Okay. You are traveling from one place to other place. Roughly you know how many kilometers it is. But once you enter into the water, wherever you see, you'll find water only. Okay. In what direction you need to travel to reach a particular particular place? Definitely, distance will not tell us. You need to go for direction. So there some magnetic compass will be there. In which direction you need to travel? Is it towards north or towards northeast or towards southwest? Time to time it will show us. Once you feed that, it will show us. Based on that, you need to travel in water. Then only you can able to reach our destination. Okay. Similarly, when you are in a flight, so flight travels at some thousands of kilometers high. There you will not find any building or anything else. There won't be any landmarks. Is it not? Only clouds will be there. Then how to travel from Bangalore to Hyderabad or from Hyderabad to some other place? Again, you will be in chaos. Yes or no? Simply from this particular city to that particular city, how many kilometers, if you know, will it solve our purpose? Definitely, it will not help you out. So again, you need to navigate there. You need to take the help of the magnetic compass and what direction it tells us. Accordingly, in that particular direction, so many kilometers if you travel, then only you are able to reach the particular place where you want to reach. Okay. So in all these examples, what we understand, distance will not solve our purpose. It is the displacement. Only displacement. If you have the idea of displacement, then only you can able to reach our destination. Hope you understood the difference between distance and displacement. Distance means only the length, whereas displacement means how much distance you need to travel in what particular direction. So direction also equally important. Okay. Thank you.